alongside Mr. Ryan Eschenberg, I'm Tanya Maya. Welcome to the Cardinal Rewind.
The Cardinal football team recently inked in some new recruits, and I actually got a chance to attend the 2010 National Signing Day. Players and media were present in the field house as football coach Mike Santiago talked about his newly signed recruits. Santiago and his staff signed 17 this spring, and all 17 are from the San Antonio area. The coaches were relieved to have this day over with and are excited about the spring season set to start in March.
There was a lot of action in women's basketball as well as a record-breaking performance. Now to the Convo. The Lady Cardinals faced the UTPB Falcons last week in the Convocation Center. Let's get straight to those highlights. Cardinals started off fresh, getting the ball to Cinnamon Kava. She drives, dishes to Haley Harvey. Good spin move, hits the jumper from the free throw line. Cardinals lead early. Kava again with a good court vision finds Nia Tarou down low for the easy layup. We'll have more on her later. Kava gets some points of her own as she takes a fast break for the easy layup. Cardinals dominated all the way throughout as Catherine Frost finds Jasmine Smith down low for the easy bucket. The Cardinals won 87-78. Haley Harvey led the Cardinals with 21 points and 10 rebounds. UTPB was led by Tammy Acosta with 22 points. The Lady Cardinals secured the regular season title and head into the Heartland Conference Tournament as the number one seed.
The men's basketball team also took the court against UTPB, and they dominated. It was senior day in the Convo, and Red the Cardinal was laying down, checking out the action. We'll get straight to second half highlights. Pierce Caldwell drives it cross court to Eric Stewart, who dishes it to Sean Ume, who drains the three from the corner. Cardinals led by 19. Some good movement here as DeLeon Hines plays a little give and go before he finds Chris Johnson for the slam. Johnson finished the game with 12 points. Late in the game, Caldwell drives, stumbles a little bit, finds Ume, who hits his second consecutive three. Cardinals are up big. They ended up winning the game 66-52. Ume led the team in scoring with 16 points. The Cardinals are on a hot streak as they have won their last six in a row. They have locked in the number one seed for the upcoming Heartland Conference Tournament. This means that the Cardinals will have a first round bye and an extra day's rest to defend their 2009 Heartland Conference title.
The NCAA Division II Swimming and Diving Championship will take place in Canton, Ohio in early March. Incarnate Word has 15 swimmers and divers going to the event with a serious chance at some national glory. One man to look out for is sophomore Patrick Cardenas, and he will swim four individual and two relay events. Good luck, and we'll have those results on our next show.
Both the men's and women's tennis teams took the short trip over to Trinity University. Both came away with 6-3 victories. The men's team jumped to 2-1 on the year, and the women's team breaks even at 2-2. The Cardinals baseball team got off to a hot start, winning their first seven games. That streak got snapped against Texas A&M Kingsville. The Cardinals are currently 13-2. Their next home game will be on March 16th against Tarleton State University. We will have highlights in our next show.
The ladies of Synchro just came back from Gainesville, where they dominated in every event they entered, including the trio and technical element competitions. The ladies won overall on the last day of the competition. Their next event is the U.S. Collegiate National Championship hosted at Stanford.
And we said we'd get back to Nia Tarou. She did have a record-breaking performance against UTPB. Do you know anything about that?
I do, actually. This is her third record that she's broken, and I got to catch up and talk with her a bit after the game. The career-high scoring record lasted 5 years, but this week Nia Tarou broke it in the game against UTPB.
When you came here 4 years ago, did you think you'd break any of these records?
I didn't at all. Like, I was just kind of clueless. I don't know. I just came out to play, and then it happened. I became the new all-time leading scorer for women's basketball in UIW history.
And what point record did you break?
It's 1,639 points, and now it's more than that in counting. So
have you ever broken any records in the past?
Well, here I've broken the single season scoring record and the steals in one game record so far, and those are the only ones I've broken.
Any records you're looking to break, maybe, that you know that you're close to breaking?
Well, not personally, but as a team, we haven't ever won conference outright, and so that's one of our biggest goals, and that's a record, so.
Okay. And how did it feel when you broke this record? I know they kind of paused and you kind of jumped up and hugged one of your friends, so how was that excitement running through you?
It was really exciting, but it was kind of weird just because it stopped the flow of the game, but it was really exciting. I never imagined it would be like that, and it was awesome.
How long do you think this new record will last?
Well, hopefully myself and Coach Henderson will do a good job in recruiting, and maybe in another 4 years from now that record will be broken again. But if it stays intact with Nia Toru, I mean, I can't think of a finer person to represent that.
All of us here at the Cardinal Rewind would like to congratulate Nia Toru on her achievement. Congratulations.
And if you have any comments or suggestions for our show, any Player of the Week suggestions, email us at uiwtv@uiwtx.edu. For all of us here at the Cardinal Rewind, it's been a pleasure. See you next time.